out for our Eagle Swag Pledge. Please repeat after me. I will soar safely in everything I do. I will work together respectfully. I will accept responsibility for my actions. I will allow my teachers to guide me towards excellence. Eagle swag is what I do. You may be seated.
Beginning a series this morning exploring the horse to human bond.
Yes, Sonia's here to tell us more about this.
Yeah, this is so interesting, you guys. So research is really still catching up in this department. What we do know is that work with animals is, of course, healing for people with a variety of conditions. This morning, we start with how horses are helping some people with autism.
All right, looking good. You ready, Brendan?
Yes.
Brendan Pritchard loves riding horses.
It makes me happy. Come on.
A longtime therapeutic equestrian rider, Brendan says horses have taught him a lot about caring, communication, and
they teach me to be confident.
What kind?
We learned about Brendan's autism early stage.
Since her son's autism diagnosis at age 3, Brendan's mom has tried a variety of therapies.
He has like music therapy and physical therapy and OT and speech.
She discovered he needed something for his body's low muscle tone, and boy, was she in for a surprise.
Our number one population or audience that we serve are people with autism.
Brendan joined EQuest 8 years ago.
That has been the best thing that we've ever done.
He is so good at riding, he joined the show team.
When he does something right and the instructor praises him, I mean, that just lifts him up.
She's a good girl.
This connection and evident joy comes as no surprise.
What I would say is it opens another pathway.
Dr. John Burris is CEO of MetroCare, the largest provider of mental health and intellectual disability services in North Texas.
And so if they can start to develop those nonverbal kinds of skills, then that can lead to improvements in the way they interact with their peers and their parents.
You know, there's just a calm when he's sitting there petting the horse and talking to the horse.
Good job.
She says riding has made Brendan more social, better with eye contact, and great at carrying on appropriate conversations.
Yay, good job, good job.
And we'll have more about EQUEST and its programs on our website, WFAA.com. By the way, next Tuesday, we explore the way horses are helping patients who have spina bifida. We talked to the mom of a precious three-year-old girl, how riding will help her physical body as she grows. That's next Tuesday.
So there's just something fundamental here in that relationship that's just so fascinating, right?
Yeah.
Across all various
Across
kinds
the
of
board,
issues.
Yeah. And it penetrates, you know, the physicality. It's really an emotional thing.
And I didn't realize until recently that there was an equestrian division even for Special Olympics.
Oh, yeah.
So getting into the competitive spirit there, too, that we all have.
And you will meet some of those athletes throughout the month.
Cool. Ah, okay.
Yeah.
Focusing on that, too.
Yep.
Thank you, Sonia. Appreciate it.